Everyone, we start with the Sankirtanam 105. എന്തെന്നാൽ അവിടെ നിന്ന് തന്റെ വിശുദ്ധ വാഗ്ദാനത്തെയും തന്റെ ദാസനായ എബ്രാഹത്തെയും അനുസ്മരിച്ചു. അവിടെ നിന്ന് തന്റെ ജനത്തെ സന്തോഷത്തോടെ തന്റെ തിരഞ്ഞെടുക്കപ്പെട്ടവരെ ഗാനാലപത്തോടെ നയിച്ചു. അവിടെ നിന്ന് ജനതകളുടെ ദേശങ്ങൾ അവർക്ക് നൽകി. ജനതകളുടെ അധ്വാനത്തിന്റെ ഫലം അവർ കൈയടക്കി. അവർ എന്നെന്നും തന്റെ ചട്ടങ്ങൾ ആദരിക്കാനും തന്റെ നിയമങ്ങൾ അനുസരിക്കാനും വേണ്ടി തന്നെ കർത്താവിനെ സ്തുതിക്കുവിൻ. നമ്മൾ ദൈവവചനമാണ് കേട്ടത്. അച്ഛൻ പറഞ്ഞതുപോലെ കർത്താവ് തന്റെ ജനത്തോടുള്ള വാഗ്ദാനത്തെ എപ്പോഴും ഓർമ്മിക്കുന്നു. അതുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മൾ ഭയപ്പെടേണ്ട. 365 പ്രാവശ്യമെങ്കിലും ബൈബിളിൽ പറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്ന വാക്കിതാണ്, നമ്മൾ ഭയപ്പെടരുത്. കാരണം ദൈവം തന്റെ ജനത്തോട് ഉച്ചരിച്ച വാഗ്ദാനം ഒരിക്കലും മറക്കുന്നില്ല, അനുസ്മരിച്ചു, അനുസ്മരിക്കുന്നു. ആ അനുസ്മരണം നമുക്കും ഉണ്ടായാൽ മതി. കർത്താവ് നമ്മളോട് ചെയ്ത വാഗ്ദാനം അവിടെ നിന്ന് അനുസ്മരിക്കുന്നത് പോലെ നമ്മളും അനുസ്മരിച്ചാൽ ധൈര്യത്തോടെ നമുക്ക് നീങ്ങാൻ പറ്റും. കാരണം മറ്റുള്ളവർ അധ്വാനിച്ച ഒരു സ്ഥലത്ത് നമ്മളെ എത്തിച്ചു, അവരുടെ അധ്വാന ഫലം ആസ്വദിക്കുവാൻ നമ്മളെ അനുവദിച്ചു. നമ്മൾ സിംഗപ്പൂരിൽ എത്തിയത് അവിചാരിതമായിട്ടല്ല, ദൈവം കണക്ക് കൂട്ടി തന്റെ വാഗ്ദാനം നിർവഹിച്ചതാണ്. തന്റെ സ്നേഹത്തിന് സാക്ഷ്യം നൽകുവാൻ, തന്റെ സാന്നിധ്യത്തിന് സാക്ഷ്യം നൽകുവാൻ, നല്ല കുടുംബജീവിതത്തിലൂടെ, നല്ല കൂട്ടായ്മയിലൂടെ തന്റെ വിശ്വാസ ജീവിതത്തെ വെളിപ്പെടുത്തുമ്പോൾ ദൈവത്തെ മഹത്വപ്പെടുത്തുകയാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. പ്രവൃത്തികളില്ലാത്ത വിശ്വാസം ജീവനില്ലാത്തതാണ്. പ്രവൃത്തികളോട് കൂടിയ വിശ്വാസം ദൈവരാജ്യത്തെ കെട്ടിപ്പടുത്തും. നിങ്ങൾ അങ്ങനെ ദൈവരാജ്യം കെട്ടിപ്പടുത്തുന്നവരാണ്. ഈ വെർച്വൽ ലിവിംഗ് എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് മാത്രം അനുഭവപ്പെടേണ്ട വരുന്ന ഒരു ദുഃഖമല്ല. ലോകമാസകലം ഇന്ന് അങ്ങനെയാണ് നീങ്ങുന്നത്. ഈ ലോക്ക്ഡൗൺ നടത്തിയത് ഇതിന്റെ സ്പ്രെഡിനെ കൺട്രോൾ ചെയ്യുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടിയാണ്. കൊറോണ വൈറസിന്റെ സ്പ്രെഡിനെ കൺട്രോൾ ചെയ്യുവാൻ വേണ്ടി ചെയ്യുന്നതാണ്. നമ്മൾ നിർബന്ധിതരായി, ലോക്ക്ഡൗൺ ചെയ്യുവാൻ നമ്മൾ നിർബന്ധിതരായി. പക്ഷേ ഈ ഒരു നിർബന്ധത്തെ നമ്മൾ ഒരു ശാപമായിട്ട് എടുക്കരുത്. ജീവിതത്തെ ഒന്നുകൂടെ ആഴത്തിൽ വിലയിരുത്തുവാൻ, ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ഇടപെടലിനെ കൂടുതൽ മനസ്സിലാക്കുവാൻ, ദൈവം തന്നെ അനുഗ്രഹങ്ങളെ ഓർത്ത് അവിടുത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുവാൻ, നന്ദി പറയുവാൻ, ഗാനങ്ങൾ ആലപിക്കുവാൻ, ബന്ധത്തിൽ കൂടുതൽ കെട്ടുറപ്പുണ്ടാകുവാൻ, ജീവിക്കുന്നു എന്ന ബോധ്യത്തോടുകൂടി ജീവിക്കുവാൻ നമ്മളെ സഹായിക്കുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടിയാണ്. നമ്മൾ ഓടിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയായിരുന്നു, ജീവിക്കുന്നു എന്ന് മനസ്സിലാക്കാതെ, ജീവിതത്തെ ആസ്വദിക്കാതെ, ജീവിതത്തിൽ ദൈവം തരുന്ന നന്മകളെ കുറിച്ച് ഒരു കൺസിഡറേഷനും ഇല്ലാതെ ഓടിക്കൊണ്ടിരുന്നവരാണ്. ദൈവം ഒരു സുല്ലിട്ടു, ഒന്ന് സുല്ലിടിപ്പിക്കുക. ഇസ്രായേൽ ജനം മരുഭൂമിയിലൂടെ നടന്നതും അതിനുവേണ്ടി തന്നെയാണ്. ദൈവമാണ് കർത്താവെന്ന് പറയുവാനും ദൈവ സാന്നിധ്യം അനുഭവിക്കുവാനും ദൈവത്തിന്റെ കൃപകളെ ഓർത്ത് നന്ദി പറയുവാനും നമ്മൾ തനിയല്ല എന്ന് ഓർക്കുന്നതിനും ദൈവം അവർക്ക് സമയം നൽകി. തപ്പിത്തടയുന്നത് പോലെ അവർക്ക് തോന്നി, ഇത്രയും സമയം വെറുതെ കളയുന്നത് പോലെ അവർക്ക് തോന്നി. പക്ഷെ വെറുതെ കളയുകയല്ലായിരുന്നു, എക്സിസ്റ്റൻസിലേക്ക് ആഴത്തിൽ ഇറങ്ങിച്ചെല്ലുകയായിരുന്നു. ഇഫ് വി ഡോണ്ട് ഗോ ഡീപ് ഡൗൺ ഇൻ ടു അവർ എക്സിസ്റ്റൻസ്, വി ഡു നോട്ട് നോ ദാറ്റ് വി ആർ റിയലി blessed with many good things in this life. To be alive is a blessing. To have a family is a blessing. To have faith in Jesus is a blessing. To have a fellowship together is a blessing. And to have a meeting like this, a bondedness, a connectedness, a support that you are receiving from one another is a blessing. We would not have been aware of all these blessings if we were running with a program and an agenda, hour to hour, running from one topic to the other, one event to the other. We would not be even deeply entering into life. Even family life was becoming more and more superficial, more and more independent. Now God is telling us to spend time with each other, quality time. give a healing presence, a loving presence to one another, rather than just running around. So our generativity has increased. And also, our leadership quality has increased. Because in our leadership quality, we have learned creative ways of leadership. That creative way of leadership is called exponential leadership. Exponential leadership is a creative mentoring leadership. A creative, innovative leadership we developed during this virtual living in our family life, in our working place. Or else we were following an autocratic leadership with expertism alone. Now we are asked to be innovative and creative, to be dynamic and to be fast. We need to be fast. Change is demanding, but change is giving a chance to come out with hidden potentials. Many unused potentials we are using. Even people like elderly people like us are learning digital living, virtual living, because we are forced into it. So we also develop certain qualities. And so we have to see the positive side of it. There are many positive side to it. Many creative games, recreational facilities we have learned. Use of social media in a balanced way. Getting connected with media. Phoning people whom we were only phoning once in a year. Maybe now we are phoning every month or every week because of our loneliness. Because we have more free time. Some have more free time. Others don't have free time at all. But all these are challenging demands on us. So let us look into each of them. Are we restricted in our movement or are we isolated with the social distancing? Are we suffering from uncertainties of job, losing job, some companies closing down, not renewing our contract, and a constant fear of getting this virus, leading to panic and anxiety? We have to look into our family dynamics, in our working dynamics, and dealing with the children and our educational setting. See, timetable has changed. Children are having classes at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the evening. And PTA meetings are at night, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. And also, we were hardly using the digital world or these media more than half an hour a day. Now maybe 3 hours to 5 hours. The other day I listened to a video. They said an average, global average is 3 hours per day. But now India is using 5 hours per day per head. This because of this present condition. So you can see how challenging it is. It is very challenging. And also many of us are multitasking. We have to deal with many things, even dealing with the bank, dealing with the shopping, dealing with children's education, communicating with families, communicating with co-workers, even job itself is from home, working at home. Work setting has shifted to home. So you can see there are many challenges. Let us go through it together like Israelites. Don't take it as a desert experience, but as a deep intimacy experience to oneself and to existence itself and to the Creator and Redeemer. Yes. How it is affecting women, let us look, because it is Seviga Sangam. You see how many things a woman is doing. Nobody knows how many things a woman is doing. She is really challenged. She is cleaning the plate. She is making chapatis. She is cleaning the house. And she is brushing things. She is feeding children. And she is having makeups. There are many items she is doing. You can see that. Yes. Working women have a jungle between multiple tasks. Office work, cooking, cleaning, groceries, taking care of children. The burden is felt more when the father works on site without a work at home option. Domestic help is unavailable. The workload causes burnout. A large number of working women have quit their jobs. Effects on health. Risk of hypertension, risk of heart attack, binge drinking. Men are going for drinking, women also are drinking due to stress and anxiety. See, whenever you have to do things fast, you know the dopamine level is very high. The serotonin level is very high whenever you are fast. When you have to work very fast, don't use so much of milk or sugar or salt. These three things make you more nervous, more restless, more hyperactive. Even for children, don't give so much of sugar, chocolates or salt. You become very much more hyperactive. Actually, the drive in life is given by the neurotransmitter dopamine and serotonin. These two things we can keep it up by communicating with one another, by having some exercise in between, having a mindfulness meditation in between, having a long bath, a massage, or having a hobby, creative hobby, or listening to music. I enjoyed the music. We started the meeting with a music, which was beautiful, very soul-touching, soul-nourishing. So these are the ways we can keep happy and alive rather than going into addictive way of eating or drinking. That is too bad. Attend to your body. Learn the theology of body and attend to your body. Respect it. Care for it. Look after yourself beautifully. Then you can spend quite a bit of time rather than looking at the negative side and murmuring. The effects on men. Yes, we all live together in the family, so the effects on men. Men do not like handling young babies or cleaning house. Small, small things, they are not having patience. The psychology of men is that they attend to big things like planning, executing, ordering around. And, immediate gratification is man's nature. They cannot postpone their desires, plans. They want to get it done. Women are more willing to wait because they are waiting in pregnancy even 9 months, isn't it? Without seeing a baby, they are loving and they are calling and talking to the baby. But men by nature is not like that. So they will find it very demanding on their energy, mental energy, emotional energy, not physical as such, with regard to the daily nitty-gritty things of family making up. ഓരോ ചെറിയ ചെറിയ കാര്യങ്ങൾ ചെയ്ത് മുഷിച്ചിൽ തോന്നുകയാണ് അവർക്ക്. അവർ ബോറടി ആകുകയാണ്, ഡിമാൻഡിങ് ആണ്. നോ നീഡ് ടു സ്പെൻഡ് ടൈം ഡ്രസ്സിങ് അപ്പ്, നോ ടൈം വേസ്റ്റഡ് ഓൺ കമ്മ്യൂട്ടിങ് ബാക്ക് ആൻഡ് ഫോർത്ത്. ഡ്രൈവ് ചെയ്യണ്ടായല്ലോ അങ്ങോട്ടും ഇങ്ങോട്ടും. പിന്നെ എപ്പോഴും കോളറും ടൈയും ഷൂസും പെയിന്റിങ്ങും ഒന്നും നടത്തേണ്ട ആവശ്യമില്ല, എല്ലാം കുറഞ്ഞു. നോ മോർ ഡീലിംഗ് വിത്ത് ഡിസ്ട്രാക്ടിങ് കോവർക്കേഴ്സ്. Demand in the co-workers, some neurotic co-workers, obsessive people, compulsive people. You don't have to be irritated with that kind of people because you are not meeting them. A recent study showed that nearly twice as many men as women reported that working from home had benefited them in their careers. Another survey indicated that fathers were 3 times more likely than mothers to receive a promotion. You see, many of them got promotion because they could concentratingly attend to their job and do well. Restriction in movement, isolation from friends and family, because many of you might have wanted to come home for Christmas, for New Year, but you couldn't make it. Social distancing, uncertainty, persistent fear of getting the corona. There has been a rise in the number of mental cases. Many people are coming for counseling with depression and anxiety, even like architects, engineers, nurses, doctors. Many of them are becoming more anxious, more worried and obsessed. With online consultations, the major age group voicing concerns were those between 21 and 30 years of age. Concerns were regarding loneliness, anxiety, stress management, and panic attack. Most of our youngsters are not taught life skills. Life skills like decision making to have more friends rather than only sticking to one or two friends. Develop more friendship. You see, start reading good books, books of people who have achieved in life, who have loved God and loved humanity and created a mark in this universe. Like, you know, the other day I was reading the article on Faraday and how he was helping in discovering electricity. He was a very dull child and failing also, but poverty. There were many obstacles, but he was willing to go. Is somebody's mic on? Yes. The thing is that, you know, the more obstacles you have got, you have to tell the children and the youth and teenagers, your frustration tolerance will increase. They have done a study in Madras showing that children and youth and teenagers who live with elderly and handicapped, they have better personality than children who receive everything in life, because frustration tolerance is high. When frustration tolerance is high, your internal resistance is high. You don't give up with blocks and problems in life. You know to wait. You know to collaborate. You know to make decision to ask help. You know to make decision to apologize and to redo it. You know to make decisions to have powerful people by congratulating and rewarding them. To be connected with the leadership intimacy, the skill of leadership intimacy, they learn it. All these happens only when you are frustrated a bit and handicapped a bit. So we have to teach the children, youth and teenagers, loneliness and anxiety is part of life. But the only way to handle is become aware, become mindful, call them by name and accept it. And tell them that it is passing. As it comes, it will be finished. One day this will be over. And remember the situations where you already overcome anxiety and loneliness in your childhood. Now you are more equipped with better choices. So you have got your own history to support you. That is what God was doing with Israelites. Remember how I brought you out. How did I divide the sea of reed? How did I fed you with manna in the desert? How did I give you water? Remembrance is going to help you, to empower you from within, to tolerate loneliness and frustration. How you have already overtaken bad and worse things than this earlier in your life, when there were abusive parents or teachers or classmates or neighbors, how you stood through it, how you accepted when you were thrown away from a job, how you waited when you were waiting for another job, how you waited when you were in debt or without money or borrowed money. So waiting in patience, kaathirippu oru valiya oru pratyasha kodukkunna onnaanu innathe logathu. ഏറ്റവും ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടുണ്ടാക്കുന്നത് ഫിയർ ഓഫ് സഫറിങ് ദർ ഈസ് നോ നീഡ് ഓഫ് ഫിയറിങ് ഓർ പാനിക്കലി അവോയ്ഡിങ് സഫറിങ് സഫറിങ് ഈസ് എ സൈൻ ദാറ്റ് യു ആർ ഓവർടേക്കിംഗ് യുവർ സിൻഫുൾ നേച്ചർ യുവർ ഇമ്പൾസീവ് നേച്ചർ ആൻഡ് യുവർ പ്ലഷർ സീക്കിംഗ് നേച്ചർ വെൻ യു നോ ടു ഓവർടേക്ക് ദാറ്റ് യു ആർ ഡെവലപ്പിംഗ് എ ക്യാരക്ടർ ടു ഹാൻഡിൽ യുവർ സെൽഫ് ആൻഡ് ഹാൻഡിൽ ദ യൂണിവേഴ്സ് handle other people, handle situations. Is it not a quality to develop? Yes. For that we need empowerment using the word of God. For those love God, everything works unto good. You have to read the word of God and empower one another. And no temptation will be too big for you, that which is not carried by the Son of God, Jesus. And you are never alone, He is with you. This kind of empowering in faith is very powerful in loneliness and anxiety and stress. Stress can be managed by remembering not only beautiful events and beautiful situations in your past life. Be connected with people who are positive and encouraging. People who give you affirmations and appreciations. നമ്മളെ പൊക്കി പറയുന്നവരും പുകഴ്ത്തി പറയുന്നവരും നമുക്ക് ഒരു പ്രചോദനം തരുന്നവരും mentoring leadership, reward leadership people are there around. അവരെ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കണം. ക്രിട്ടിസൈസ് ചെയ്യുന്നവരെയും നെഗറ്റീവ് ആയിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞ് നമ്മളെ ഡിപ്രഷനിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുപോകുന്നവരെ അവോയ്ഡ് ചെയ്യുക. എന്നിട്ട് പോസിറ്റീവ് ആയിട്ട് പറയുന്നവരും പോസിറ്റീവ് എൻകറേജ്മെന്റ് തരുന്നവരെയും കണ്ടുമുട്ടുക. Effects on children and youth. See, they may be stuck to mobile. Because of their loneliness, there is a chance of getting stuck with mobile. We have to be careful. Have a look at them and communicate with them. Give them some family involvement, homemaking. Make them also involved in cooking. That's what we are doing here. Every parent, we tell them, help them. ചക്ക വെട്ടാനും കപ്പ ഞുറുക്കാനും മീൻ ക്ലീൻ ചെയ്യാനും വെജിറ്റബിൾ കട്ടിങ്ങും കുക്കിങ്ങിനും എല്ലാത്തിനും പെൺപിള്ളേരെ ആൺപിള്ളേരെ ഉപയോഗിക്കുക. എ നെഗലറ്റേറിയൻ വേ ഓഫ് ലൈഫ് ഹാസ് ടു ബി ടോട്ട്. ഹോം മേക്കിംഗ് പിള്ളേരെ ഒരിക്കലും പഠിക്കാനായിട്ട് മാത്രം ഇരുത്തരുത്. ടെൽ ദം ടു കോഓപ്പറേറ്റ് ഇൻ ഹോം മേക്കിംഗ്, ഇൻ ക്ലീനിങ്, ഇൻ കുക്കിംഗ്, ഇൻ ഷോപ്പിംഗ്, ഓൺലൈൻ ബിസിനസ്, ഫോർമുലേറ്റിംഗ് ലെറ്റേഴ്സ്, റീഡിംഗ് ബുക്സ്, leading prayer groups, having connected prayer groups, recreational groups. We have got now connected recreation groups, connected prayer groups, connected Bible study group, connected quiz formation group. We need to have innovative way of finding, getting connected these children so that they are not stuck with mobile alone. Increased screen time is bad, because their relationship with the surrounding world will be cut off. And also, my staff here, they all are highly educated from Calcutta or from Madras or from Chennai. They are telling, the more you use mobile, this blue light is bad for the eye and also bad for the brain. So, for a long time, if you are stuck with the screen, that is going to really create havoc in your future, in your memory, in your creative thinking. You know, creative thinking, empathy, decision making and problem solving, we need to think outside the box, isn't it? If you don't think outside the box, tell the children, you cannot just think about going to the school and doing the homework, appearing an exam, no. Think creatively and find ways of learning and doing homework and assignments and have a group together so that you are not bored. So this is very important. Sleep deprivation should be avoided. Addiction, if they get addicted with emotionally thinking only about their mobile and their computer, that's bad. That's going to affect their overall development, because the social skill, the emotional skill of empathy and relationship is happens only with interaction, not with mobile or with the media alone. But at the same time, let me tell you, digital world is important, because yesterday I heard a video. Kodak was a company who didn't want to make their cameras digital world, but that company had to be closed down. So change is inevitable, though it is challenging and demanding, though it has got a risk. In a balancing way, we have to teach them to use the digital world and media. There is no other choice. In the church, in the parish, in teaching, in study, in prayer, in recreation, in education, in travel, in social connection, in shopping, in many areas, in art and music. There is no other way. We have to have the skill. We have to upgrade and update. There is no other way, because the artificial intelligence and robots are going to be the next challenge. The other day I saw a lady with a mobile phone installed in the hand. She has no mobile in the hand. She is talking from the hand without mobile because it is installed. You'll be surprised. So what happens if you are so much wired and wired with Wi-Fi? It is dangerous. But balance it, be learning and really make use of. Next. Yes, confinement at home also leads to weight gain. Many children are putting on weight, including us. We are also putting on weight because we don't have to walk, we don't have to run for a bus, we don't have to start a car, we don't have to go on shopping or visiting the sick. There are many ways. Your body is also talking to you. There are many anxiety, painful memories in the cellular body. So please attend to your body with the jogging exercise, breathing exercise, yoga. All these are very important. And going for massage, maybe foot massage below the knee. You have to do reflexology, hand massage, different kind of small exercises, tapping on the elbow, tapping on the palm of the hand, and interlocking the fingers, massaging the forehead, massaging under the eye, corner of the eye, the clavicles, the under the axilla. These are all spots where neurotransmitters are created, like dopamine and serotonin. When you don't have much physical activity, these are simple techniques of emotional freedom technique, emotional regulation and body exercise to have enough neurotransmitters for mental health and physical health. Online classes require self-discipline. Children need to be assisted to sit with the online classes and do assignments in time. Postponing is a bad technique. The youth and children and teenagers have to be taught to be assertive enough. Assertiveness demands that never to postpone. Have enough self-love to attend to your job, to attend to your need, and to attend to your responsibility. That is assertiveness and self-love. Self-love and self-care is a must to grow in life and to keep healthy in mind and body. This responsibility often is burdened on the shoulders of parents who are already struggling. Children under 5, children under 12, they all need assistance and discipline to attend to the online classes. Even catechism classes, we have to arrange online, and we have to help them make it more, creative. Give a little banana nearby. Give a little juice that they like to sip in between. Give them a little kind of positive stroke, a little hug, a little pat on the head or shoulder, so that they are not bored and lonely. Children are suffering maximum in this virtual world. Please be empathetic to their need and their struggle. Please don't shout at them. Don't be very negative with them, but encourage and support. Supervision. Okay, they are not getting one-to-one face or eye contact, and they are not getting, you know, any kind of attention. You see, usually attention span is only 40 minutes. Children with hyperactivity, they have only 15 to 20 minutes. Ordinary healthy child has got only 40 minutes. So you can understand when the class is going on for 1 hour, 2 hours, how restless they are. They develop anxiety. So we need to help them, give them at least bath twice, give them hug, give them positive feedback, give them non-calorie diet, not sugar and salt, not Lays and ice creams, but fruits and fruit juice and homemade items. Drink plenty of water, do little jogging inside, have little games so that they are creatively, their mind is occupied. Laugh therapy, make them to laugh and jump around. Yes. How do we change the situation? Stay connected to family and friends. Video calls, social media platform. Tell them to make video calls. Relaxation. Every child is taught here meditation from the age of 6. Only 5 to 10 minutes meditation we can teach them, just telling one mantra, Jesus or Maranatha or any word, I Amen, 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 or Alleluia, or Parishuddhan. One word meditation, 5 to 10 minutes. And breathing, awareness of breathing in and out, with awareness of the movement of the abdomen, chest, neck, the cold breeze coming in and the warm breath going out. Become aware. You use all the 5 senses. The smell, memory of nice smell, memory of nice sight, memory of walking in the villages of your hometown. Remember that you are in another country and another land. But in between, you have to go back into your own village, enjoy the smell of your village, the coffee flower, the tea plantation flower, the elanji puva, mulla puva. You go into your memory in smell. Go into your memory in taste, eating the food that your mom gave. Go into your memory in your eyesight, how your dad is and mom is looking at you and smiling. Hear the words of mom and dad calling your name, the loved ones, the teacher affirming you, your classmates calling you a friendly call, your name. These are important. All 5 senses are to be awakened in through meditation. Seek help when overwhelmed. Don't be shy. Have the courage to get help. You need a overpowering of your positive side and a diminishing of your negative side. You can only replace with the help of a third party. So seek help when overwhelmed. Try learning new techniques, hobbies. Why? I know Singapore is a small place, but small hobbies like stitching, painting, these are important. Writing with the left hand, doing little painting with your present emotional condition. You can depict projectively by writing a story or painting. These are important. How do we change the situations? You see, we cannot instruct companies and government, but you can instruct yourself and your family. Okay, that is all. I can go on telling. If you want to ask me some questions, you can ask me in between, because there are many questions which I can answer. If you ask me practically, it may be easier. Do you see, some people are afraid of Google. Some people are afraid of phone being hacked. Some people are afraid of sitting at home alone. Why? There is no need of giving so much time and space for anxiety and fear. Rather, think about the positive things in your life you have already achieved. Memories can awaken energy within you. In NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, we say that location is not the map, isn't it? Why location is not the map? Don't think negatively of any location or any activity or any event. You can paint over it with the color that you like and change the imagery positive. These are some of the techniques. Why don't you, some of you, join online counseling class? We give online counseling class for 5 months, the late evenings, between 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. Maybe it is 9 o'clock there. But learning always divert your attention and give you more creative space and more hope in life, more energy to look forward. Don't block your vision of life. Always have a vision in your life by learning. Never stop learning. In US only I learned, some of my classmates were in their late 60s. They are learning. They come for counseling course. They are learning because in human capacity till the age of 60, you have only used 2/3 of your energy. 1/3 of your energy is still remaining. That is, these are the wise years, wisdom years, golden years with experience, love, empathy, faith, courage, stability, emotional balance, gratitude, satisfaction, joy of life, trust in God, trust in humanity. These are qualities which you develop when you are in your late 50s and 60s. So why don't you use it for pastoral counseling, palliative visit to sick people and elderly people and cancer patients and handicapped people? And you yourself will find meaning in your life when you enter into the troubled people's life, the marginated and the broken. We are broken people, the wounded healers. Let us continue. Don't be ashamed that we are wounded healers. Everyone is. Everyone is. We all are ordinary and average. It's okay to be ordinary and average. What is important is that be satisfied and joyful. God wants us to be joyful and satisfied. പിലിപ്പയരുടെ ലേഖനത്തിൽ പറയുന്നത് നമ്മൾ ഓർക്കുക, റിജോയ്സ് ഇൻ ദ ലോർഡ് ഓൾവേസ്. റിജോയ്സ്, ഐ ടെൽ യു, ബിക്കോസ് യു ഹാവ് എ ലൈഫ് വെർ യു ക്യാൻ ലവ് പീപ്പിൾ ടിൽ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ബ്രത്ത്. ഈവൻ യുവർ ഡെത്ത് ഹാസ് ടു ബി എ വിറ്റ്നസ് ഓഫ് പീസ് ആൻഡ് ജോയ്, കണ്ടൻമെന്റ്. യു സീ, എവറി പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ലൈഫ് ഈസ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ആൻഡ് പ്രഷ്യസ്. സോ കീപ് ലേണിംഗ്. You can contact Trada, tradingtrada@gmail.com. The online counseling course is going on. Many people from US and UK and Australia are joining. But because we have very little contact with Singapore, we never contacted you. But people from Kuwait, at least 12 of them are doing online counseling. Why I am telling this? Empowering yourself is one method of keeping alive. Keeping energy spot in your life. Always be energetic, okay? You have to check up. Medical checkup is important every month. After the age of 40, 35, medical checkup is important. And why don't you have a coffee hour together? Though you people are in your homes, tell everybody at 10 o'clock, put on the video, let us chat and have coffee hour together. Have a biscuit. Though we are not sharing biscuit and coffee, we can share our joy and enthusiasm, isn't it? And why don't you tell each one when they get up early morning to have a network of reading Bible together? Why don't you in the evening tell all of them, the children, to have a game together and quest together? Not only drinking or eating chicken and mutton, but let us love our life. Love our very being, not only body, mind and spirit is equally important. Soul nourishing and mind nourishing are needed. It happens with connectedness with God and one another. Let us not forget, be connected with nature, be connected with the people, be connected to your own body through exercise and through attending to self-care and creativity and hobbies and compassionate work. A compassion-focused therapy says that be compassionate to your own self. Do justice to your own self. If you are not alive and happy, how can you make another happy? How can you console and give hope to another? So it's important that you rejoice and be alive. I know Marthomates are very up to date with virtual living or digital world or media use, because I know them in US a lot. And in UK, Canada, they are very up to date. And I am sure in Singapore also you are doing it. All the best. May God bless you. You can ask me further questions.
If any one of you have questions, sister will take them now. You can unmute yourself or drop the questions in the chat box. We already have our first question.
Yes.
One of from a member. Dr. Joanne, you mentioned yoga. Some people hold yoga as un-Christian. Could you share your view on this?
The thing is that we don't have to use om or what do you call all kinds of words that they use, like Surya Namaskar or om. These are kind of nature worship or calling on a god that we do not know. Okay, but we can have exercise of the body with awareness and breathing, isn't it? The theology of body says that God has created human body as the temple of the Holy Spirit. Incarnation itself, he says that God becoming man has sanctified human body and human existence and everything in this universe, isn't it? What is incarnation? God becoming man. So let us not become so critical about the terms others are using. We need not use them. But yoga is an awareness and integration awareness technique of body, mind and spirit. Okay? Is it not? What do we say in St. Luke Gospel? Zachariah taking the child in the hand, what did he say? Glory to Israel and a light to all nations. Is not Jesus beyond Christianity? Jesus is beyond Christianity. Yes, he is a light to all nations. So we need to have a wider understanding of our faith in Jesus. Okay? Let us not condemn our body or any bodily exercises. Let us be positive.
Sister, I have one question. Yeah.
Yes.
In today's world, I mean, I have already written it on my phone, so I'm just looking at my phone. In today's world, when communication and even maintaining relationships with each other is through virtual, so everything is virtual now, what will be the future of our young generations? Like, will they find any real meaning in relationships? As now, getting connected with their own extended families is also through virtual. So,
you see, getting connected in any method is equally good. Only the thing is that eye contact, emotional warmth,
yes,
touch, these are missing. That is why I told you, in your own family, you hug one another, hug the children at least 3 times a day. You understand? Nothing is going to go wrong. Whenever you are connected, you remember in our younger days, I was working in Africa, a letter comes only once in a month. Did I lose with my connection with my parents or my brothers, sisters? Never. You see, connectedness itself is the joy of life. Only a paper came, not even a video camera or a telephone connection with Africa. You understand? Connectedness means in prayer you use them, in talk you use it, in memory you use it, in one another's touch you use it, and whenever you get opportunities, you get connected. You will not go. But it is important for parenting to take a different style. The churches to take it a different style. The traditional method is not working. We have to be very innovative and creative in getting connected. That's all. That needs everybody to shake up. Okay?
Yeah, thank you, sister.